Hey guys, hello world. My name is Anna, and in this video, I'm gonna share with you my story of how I became a programmer with no experience and degree and share my tips of how to do the same faster. So this video will be divided in two parts. In the first part, I'll be talking about my own experience, my background and career journey. Also, some tips will be included, so don't skip this part. And in the second part of this video, I'll be sharing the tips on how to learn to code and how to get a job faster. Let's go. In 2018, I was graduated with, I got a bachelor's degree at the University of Moscow, and my major was Asian studies, so nothing about coding. I learned languages, primarily Chinese was my specialty. And at the end of my studies, I found a job at the small agency, marketing agency, which promoted some Russian goods to China. And it was really cool. It was an exciting journey. And I've been working there for like 1 year and a half. And I decided to quit in October 2019. So I started in April 2018, quit in October 2019. And within this kind of experience in marketing, I realized that it is not my thing, and I was searching somewhere else. And I was thinking about why not to code. And I discovered, that's how I discovered a Fridge school. If you don't know what it is, I have plenty of videos. I'll put the link down below this video. So I did the, while working, I decided to be enrolled in their program and pass their first sort of a test, which lasts 1 month, and it is called PCM, and I did it in August 2019, and I failed. And it was like very frustrating for me, honestly. But I didn't give up, so I tried to learn a little bit on my own, but didn't literally learn. And what I told myself is that I will try again, because I was really into this learning system. I really liked the school approach. So I really wanted to be in this community. That's why I decided to do it again. And I heard that there was the campus that opened in Moscow. Yeah, I tried the first PCM in Paris, in the original school. And I told myself, why not try it in the place where I live, actually, lived by the time in Moscow. And in the meantime, I actually did some side jobs as teaching languages. For you to understand that I didn't have like all of the free time to prepare, to learn on my own, I succeeded. For the second time, I got into the school. I was super happy, super excited. So this is how my learning path started. And I did it in February 2020. So this is the enrollment period of 1 month. And then I started my studies at the end of April in 2020. While studying, I still had my side jobs as a teacher. I taught English, Chinese, a little bit of French. So I had some side work and I was studying. So this period was really tough. I strongly recommend you, if you have the opportunity, the money, to live without working, do that and concentrate on studying. I didn't have this opportunity. It was really, really tough to combine both things. But anyway, I didn't fail, because this thing of becoming a software developer was in my mind, and I repeated myself that I have to be strong, I have to be motivated and to find the force to study.
I will find out what to do. I'll be strong.
So at the end of August 2021, so it's been like almost 1 year and a half since I started learning programming, I found my first internship at the company called Spare Devices. It was really cool opportunity, exciting team, exciting people. I'm so happy that I had such an experience. By the way, I have like a series of videos dedicated on that, where I shared my experience in searching for and finding finally the first internship. I documented everything, put the playlist down below this video. And then after 3 months, they took me as a full-time position in their company, in the particular team where I worked. So what we did, probably because I didn't really tell in my videos what we did. So it was like in smart devices, they primarily focus on smart devices like smart home, a sort of a voice assistant like Alexa, but in Russian, it's called Salut. Voice assistant and this technology of the assistant who replies thanks to AI and algorithms, it has interactions with user and it has the history of interactions with user. So the goal of my team was to keep all of the data with interactions with user and the voice assistant. And then the other guys from our team was analyzing everything. And actually we also created an app based on this kind of storage of what we kept and we had a sort of internal analytical platform, which we created. So I was not only creating the backend for that, for this platform and for the sort of app which stored everything, but sometimes I had to write some scripts, analytical scripts, and that was really exciting because I never did that. I'm really happy that I had such an experience. As for a technological stack, it was primarily Java, and I learned Java before applying for the internship. So, really cool language. I miss it now because I've worked for this company till April 2022 and I moved to Paris in January. So I worked remotely a little bit, but then all of the political situation in the world is sort of an instability. I decided to search for a new job in Paris with a small, with less than a year of experience, which was kind of hard, but it was doable. And not only I found a job in 1 month, I also found a job in another field. So that's why I told that I kind of miss a little bit the Java, because right now my technological stack is JavaScript, TypeScript. It's neither front end nor back end. So back to track. In April, I signed an offer from the company called Content Square as a software developer. I was super excited. And in June 2022, I started my work there. So that's, in short, my career path in programming. I still feel like I'm a newbie here, but I do my best to learn more, to be more professional, and to get as much experience as I can and grow as a software developer. By the way, this story of finding a job in France, I'm currently sharing it on Instagram with the hashtag JobInFrance_GordonGirl. Part two, advice based on my own experience. First of all, how to learn coding. I would recommend to be enrolled in a coding bootcamp, a sort of a coding bootcamp, or buy a course with a guided program. If you're hesitating whether the programming is for you or not, try to start learning yourself. There are lots of free resources online. I always recommend the course called from Harvard University called CS50. Check it out, link in the description. It's an amazing course for beginners to understand what the programming is. Why don't I recommend complete self-studying? First of all, it's easy to be lost because there are tons of millions of materials, resources to learn. And when you just start, it's very easy to get lost within all of this information. So it's better if you have a sort of a path to go through. And the second thing is that it's really easy to be discouraged, unmotivated. Learning programming might be really challenging sometimes, and it's very important to have a sort of support, peers that surround you, people who fully understand your struggles and difficulties. Sharing your knowledge, the experience that you discovered, it also helps to learn faster. And being surrounded by motivated people as you are, smart people, people who have same goals as you have. and so that you make progress fast, as if you learn to programming yourself completely. But it's not like a blocker, it's just a recommendation, and if you feel like you can do it yourself, why not? As for the courses, just I don't have, so the video is not sponsored, only 42 school is in my heart, but I know that it's not for everyone, and right now I know that there are also many good courses that exist, many good coding bootcamps, but I just want you to have to always have this criteria in mind when you choose. First of all, is that in this course, bootcamp, there should be more practice than theory. Like I would say 80% of practice, 20% of theory. You can find yourself a theory, but it's very important, like if you have practice, if this kind of tasks, projects that you do, they are checked by someone, evaluated by someone, and that you are given appropriate advice. Algorithms and data structures is in the course because it's important. And the third criteria I would say would be partnerships with, if this kind of program have partnerships with other companies who might hire you at the end of the course, or have special programs of hiring people with special situations, I mean, without a degree. Because sometimes finding a job yourself might be very challenging. I know, particularly in some countries, because many HRs, they require the degree, even though the team might not need you to have a degree where they're searching for the intern, but you know, the rules of the company are like that and they can't neglect the rules, so you're by default you're out at the beginning. So it's important that this course have partnerships, since you are in this world of software development, of IT industry, if you have your first experience, then it would be way easier to follow along, you know. At least if you have like 3 months of an internship, it will be way easier to find something. And the last point about the learning process, make learning programming your number one priority. In my programming journey at the beginning, I tried to combine my studies, as I told you, with a sort of a side job. I taught languages, as I told you. And sometimes it would take 20 hours per week, sometimes it would take 40 hours per week. And, you know, additionally studying was really, really hard. And I think it slowed me down, probably. But I don't regret anything, but I believe that it slowed me down. And it took a lot of energy, balancing between social life, studying and work. It was really consuming, and I think I was at the point of the burnout. Hopefully I didn't have it, but I was very, very close to that. But at the point, I remember it was April 2021, I decided to like stop teaching and sacrificed all of my time in learning programming. And here I saw huge progress, enormous results comparing to what I had while working. The second part of the second part is my advice, my tips on how to find a job. First of all, right now there are a lot, the standards are getting higher and higher. You have to learn and know more and more for the entry level jobs. So I would suggest to start with an internship and not having high standards on the company or what you would do, whether it's super interesting or not. And the same as salary expectations. Don't have a lot of salary expectations. I worked for the job of an intern for 3 months, and it was okay. The goal is to have the experience. Since you have the experience, since you have this knowledge, then you can negotiate your salary, then you can negotiate your conditions and to do very cool and interesting stuff, and choose if you have a different choice. You know, second tip about finding a job is concerned about the interviews. Prepare well, and especially prepare your pitch on your experience and on your motivation. I think on interviews, you should prove the interviewer that you are ready to learn, that you are highly motivated, that you work hard, etc., that you can achieve your results. And even if you lack some experience, that you are highly motivated, that you learn fast, that you have a lot of autonomy, and you are ready to face new challenges and problems at work. So if you want, it's extremely big topic on how to prepare for interviews. If you want me to make a proper video on that, leave a comment. The third tip on finding a job is to use various channels, LinkedIn, Facebook, different platforms, websites. By the way, I will share some in France, which I used in France in the description. And don't underestimate the power of the word of mouth. In my case, this channel was the most effective, the most useful, and thanks to that, I got my job at Content Square and had a potential job offer at another company. And the last but not least, don't be afraid to fail. All of the failures will finally lead to success. And the thing is that it's very important to fail. Failures give us this precious experience and knowledge what went wrong and how to improve. Think about failures as the opportunity of how to improve rather than the end of the world and I don't know anything. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope it was useful for you and at least gave you some thoughts that you didn't have. Let me know what you think in the comment. Remember that everything is possible. Try, and this will lead you to success. Thank you again, and see you in my other videos. Bye bye.